Okay, what are the holes and how are you trying to fill them in?
Well, the way I see it is that at the end of the day, people want to be self-actualized. They want to live their own version of freedom culture. They want to find a way to earn a living and play a role and a purpose in society. But the way I see it is that right now, traditional education systems aren't doing that. They're not allowing for real mentorship in the creation of what they're learning and what they're absorbing in schools. So how do we bridge that gap? How do we allow people to be able to learn from people who have actually done the work and not just from textbooks and theory? And I mean, there's no doubt about the fact that there's a crisis going on in America and around the globe for student debt. So finding a cheaper way to democratize that, to putting out this kind of content and allowing people from around the globe to actually access this information, I mean, that makes a lot of sense. I mean, even the textbooks themselves are outdated by the time they're printed. Mm-hmm. Right. So there's always something going on. I mean, we feel the pulse here. It's alive. It's happening at all times. So how do we tap into that?
How
do we tap into that?
How do you? How do you guys do this?
Well, to me, the fastest way is going through the process of putting this content online, realizing that the new television is now live streamed on Facebook and Instagram and all these different places. So education is a frame of mind. It's something that's happening at all times. And the way I see it is everybody wants to be better than the person they were yesterday. And the fastest way to do that is to become smarter. It's to educate yourself, to find ways to learn more about the world around you, no matter the topic. And so that's what Superhero Academy is about.
And what about this idea of this freedom culture? Is that something that every individual can actually afford? Not all of us can pursue what we love to do and you know, be able to do that for the rest of our lives.
Well, I don't believe that freedom culture is the kind of thing that we have to buy or that there's something that needs to happen. We have to understand that it starts with your own clarity and commitment, understanding where you want to go and what you want to do. Now, of course, some of us have dreams that are way too expensive for us to afford, right? And we need to find ways to enable that further. I believe that systematically we can build systems and schools and education that can actually support this in a powerful way. And I'm seeing it happen. I mean, you know, we experienced a 100x growth on Superhero Academy Online. It was incredible what was able to go down. And that wasn't because of the fact that we were raising the price. It wasn't because we were being exclusive. It's actually because we lowered the price. So I do believe there's a disruption in education happening at the moment, and we'll continue to see that happen.
Who's the target audience for this? Is this high schoolers? Is it people that are about to go into the college application process? Who is it?
I would have thought that, honestly, I really would have thought it would have been millennials. I really would have thought that people were coming through education, the college system, maybe coming out without getting a job or anything like that, that they would be the most drawn in. But what we're noticing is that empty nesters, women particularly, who really want to change their careers. They want to step up into something new, or maybe all of a sudden their kids are off to college and they want to step into a new career path. So it's been fairly varied. We've had students apply from pretty much all over the globe, from Asia to Australia to Canada, America. I mean, it's pretty varied. It's pretty worldwide.
That's amazing. And you also have an idea of redefining what ROI stands for. Return on investment is what we're used to down here on Wall Street. What does ROI mean to you?
Well, I don't want to cancel out the ROI of return on investment. I mean, if you're going to learn how to be a creative, a freelancer, an entrepreneur of any kind, you definitely have to track what is happening on these screens and happening in your own company. But I also believe that we need to find ways to track the ROI of ripple of impact. The thought that there is so many consequences to our actions, to what happens on Wall Street, to what happens in business, and recognizing that has environmental impacts. We can track the social economic impact of that. We track something differently. And I don't know how to measure that yet. That's something we need to figure out.
The debate about whether or not higher education, if it's worth it for a lot of people, it's gaining more traction. We're seeing a lot more people really start to have that conversation about, is going to college even worth it with how many people have student loans?
Totally.
But do you feel that the higher education system has failed us?
I do. I really do. I believe it's failed me personally. I mean, I think it's because we're not trained to actually understand how to do a job. We're not really trained to come out into the marketplace and know what we actually are doing. I mean, how many people become lawyers and never spent a single day with a lawyer? How many people become any job without ever spending time actually learning what that's like? And in our generation, the millennial generation, we have less commitment nowadays. Mm-hmm. We're less likely to want to stay. We have less loyalty to a job. And so I think a lot of people are disillusioned, and that debt that they took on getting some science major or whatever, and then all of a sudden realizing that that's not what they want, that can be really costly. And I think we're going to see the effects in the market as the market continues to plunge.
And part of your solution, too, is to have that Johnny Tremaine method, right, of apprenticeship. And we've seen a lot of schools adopt that, too, going back to that vocational model.
Exactly. Yeah, I think it's beyond time that we get back to this. I believe it's the fastest way we can run people through an education. In a year, you can learn everything you need to know and the specifics of that job versus spending, 4 years in college, ending up in an enormous amount of debt and not really actually having the tangible skill sets you need.
All right, Mark, great stuff. Keep up the good work. Mark Angelo Coppola is the founder of Superhero Academy. Thanks again for joining us.
Thank you
so much.